the microscope the male cone always growing cluster, hai na, it is grow on the in the cluster at the tip of the long shoot. From outside little elongated structure, we see it is a long slight elongated structure, the end it is a hard and woody, hard and woody. This structure enlarge we see in the LS of microsporophyll, the spirally arranged microsporophyll around the central axis. The microsporophyll contain two microsporangia which contain the microspore mother cells which undergo meiosis provide the microspore. The microspore giving to change microspore give rise to change the pollen grain, act as a give rise the pollen grain. The pollen grain of the gymnosperm of the pinus is a two-walled structure. This is the pollen grain and having the two wall, this is the entine and the outer wall form the wings. So this is the exile. This is the pollen grain. It is covered by two layer. Inner one is entine, the outer one is exine. So the exine form the wings. That wings help in the pollination. So the pollination in the pinus is of anemophilus. Anemophilus. Anemophilus means pollination or dispersal done with the help of wing. In the anemophilus, the wings are there. The axine forms the wings that help in pollination. So the pollination is like wing, and through these wings, it has to reach over the megaspore. So when the pollination is occur, they release from the microsporophyll, and the pollen grains are yellow color, yellow sulfur color. Not the sulfur present in it. So the sulfur color powdery mass. So the very large number of pollen grain are released from the microsporangia. So they are yellow sulfur color. They are yellow color as a sulfur is there. No sulfur is found. Keep this point in mind. Yellow color. Releasing very large number, and when the pollination is there, when the pollination in the pinus forest, in the pine forest, the yellow color dust is so seen clearly there. So these yellow dust are called sulfur cloud. When the pollination is there, all around the yellow color dust like substance is there. That is called sulfur cloud. Sulfur cloud is nothing but it is the pollen grains. These are the pollen grains. They spread around the pine forest. So now pollen grain with the help of wing, they have to reach on the male, female or mega sporophyll. This is the female cone. Female cone, or we can say the female strobilus. It is longer than the male. It is longer than the male, and the megasporophyll surrounded the center axis. They are also arranged in a spiral manner. The sporophyte at the axil of the leaf. It is present, for example, this is the plant of the pinus plant. This is the pinus plant, and these are the shoot, dwarf shoot, and here the scaly leaf. So it is found at the base of scaly leaves. Now, the bracts are there. The this is the megasporophyll. It has the two types of scale or bracts. So number one, it is the oviliferous scale, and this the small one is the bract scale. So bract scale, the small one, it's helping the when the wind pollination is there. The microspore reach on the megasporophyll. We have discussed it is a naked seeded plant. The fruit is not there. The ovule is naked. So when the pollen grain reach over, they remain stick to here. So the wind pollination, the time period between the pollination and fertilization is about 15 months. The time period between the pollination and fertilization is 15 months. When there is a no covering is there, when the pollen grain come, they shed off. So for remaining, for the attachment or for the attachment of the pollen grain. So these are the pollen grain. This grooves is there. The bract scale make the groove. So bract scale, upon the bract scale, the pollen grain remain here for a longer period. So the pollen grain come here, stay here, and the bract scale trap them. So the cones, the female cones female cone is developed within the 2 to 3 years. When it is a newly formed, when it is a developed, when it has to be developed, it is compactly arranged. It is compactly arranged when the second year is there, third is there, the space has developed. Means when it is new, the sporophylls are compactly arranged. When it is matured, the 2 year, 3 year old, the gap should be maintained. The gap is developed. So the first year cone, these leaves are very close, and when it grows, it get the space and distance between the sporophyll. The large woody ovule, this is the woody oviliferous scale. So the oviliferous scales are woody, brown color, and the smaller are the bract scale. So pollen grains come here, the pollination is done. The megasporophyll we have drawn here. So megasporophyll contain the two megasporangia. So these are the ovule. Within the ovule, the egg is there. So the two ovules are there. Inside the ovule, egg is there. And the ovule is an orthotopous type. Orthotopous type, within it is the egg is there. So the female, this is the megasporophyll, two megasporangia are there, in which the ovule is there, two megasporangia, two ovule are there, within the ovule the egg is there. So thus learn this point, the orthotopous ovule and the unitegmic, the orthotopous is the characteristic feature of the gymnosperm. So just learn this point, the characteristic feature of the pinnaceous orthotopous ovule. Now the pollen grain come here, and by the elongation of the these are the wings. Wings are there, the entire elongate, and the pollen tube is formed. The pollen tube enter the female cone, come into the female cone, and the fertilization is there. The fertilization product is zygote. What is formed? The zygote is formed, and the zygote develop into the embryo. The zygote develop into the embryo. So embryo is formed फ्यूजन
ऑफ मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट इज देयर.
पॉलिनेशन फर्टिलाइजेशन
इज डन. आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन द जाइगोट इज फॉर्म. देन द ओव्यूल इज एम्ब्रियो इज फॉर्म. द एम्ब्रियो दैट गिव राइज द सीड. एम्ब्रियो दैट गिव राइज द सीड. नो फ्रूट फॉर्मेशन इज देयर. सो सीड इज नेकेड. दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड द नेकेड सीडेड प्लांट. द वन स्पीशीज ऑफ द पाइनस. पाइनस जियार्डियाना. पाइनस जियार्डियाना द फ्रूट ऑफ पाइनस जियार्डियाना. Is called chilgoza. Chilgoza, that is the dry fruits. The fruit of the Pinus giardiana is edible. That is chilgoza. And the fruits of other gymnosperm is eaten by the animals. So this is the characteristic feature of the gymnosperm. Number one, the orthotropous ovule. And the ovule is a single, has a single covering. Single covering, so it is called unitagmic. So keep this point in mind. These are the characteristic feature of the gymnosperm. Now in the next video, we discuss the angiosperm, the flowering plant. The bryophyte, pteridophyte, in bryophytes, we have discussed the in bryophyte, the predominant phase, the mainly the part of the plant body is we are writing here what we have discussed up to here. Number one, bryophytes, pteridophyte we discuss, gymnosperm. And next we discuss the angiosperm. In bryophyte, the dominant phase, the predominant phase, the part of the plant remaining for a longer time, the diploid or haploid. So dominant phase is gametophyte in bryophyte. In pteridophyte, it is changed, the sporophyte is there. Sporophyte, the spore producing. In gymnosperm, also the sporophytic phase is the dominant phase. In angiosperm, also the sporophytic phase. Bryophyte, dominant phase is gametophyte, and the pteridophyte, gymnosperm, angiosperm, the diploid is sporophytic means diploid, the spore producing phase is sporophyte. So the angiosperm we discuss in the next lecture, next video, angiosperm, the flowering plant.